Hello and welcome to Stand Taller. I'm your host, author of the book Stand Taller. My name's Alex MacDonald, and this podcast here is designed to help you learn how to pivot your beliefs so that you can stand taller. If you want to conquer your negative beliefs and start living a life of possibility and victory, so much for tuning in. We're gonna have a great time. I am so grateful that you're tuned in. Thanks for listening. I recently listed my motorcycle for sale on the marketplace. Had quite a few responses. Great price on it. One guy sent me a message saying, "How low can you go?" And I replied, "Well, probably about 2 miles an hour. Anything slower and you'll probably fall over." Well, the guy hasn't responded. He actually even blocked me. Now, did you hear about the new restaurant called Karma? Yeah, there's no menu. You just get what you deserve. How many therapists does it take to screw in the light bulb? Only one. But the light bulb really has to want to change. Now, these are some bad jokes intentionally. I'm trying to get us off on the right foot, get us in the right mood. We take our mission very seriously, but we don't take ourselves very seriously at all. Life is about having fun, and this is about having fun, making money, and making a difference. So I'm so glad you're here. This is my last joke. Did you know that when you go to a different room in your home, you can actually change your citizenship? Yeah, when you go to the restroom, you're a peeing. We're going to have bad jokes every single episode just to kick off each one. And thank you so much for being here. Now, I'd love to share a story with you. And this story is of an old man and his dog sitting on the porch. It's hot outside and the old man, he's sipping his lemonade. And the old dog is sitting next to him just howling in pain. There's this salesman, he's in the neighborhood. He's going door to door trying to sell his wares. He goes to a house down the street and he faintly hears the dog howling and whimpering, groaning and moaning. And then he notices as he comes out the house, he still hears the dog just howling away. So as he gets closer, he still hears the dog howling and the curiosity gets the best of him. So he makes his way down to the house where the old man is sitting on the porch, sipping the lemonade. And he asks the old man, he said, "Why is your dog howling in pain?" The old man responds by saying, "Oh, that dumb dog is sitting on a nail." Perplexed, the salesman asks, "Well, why doesn't the dog just get up and move to another spot on the porch?" The old man takes another sip of his lemonade, smiles, and thinks about his response and says, "Well, dang, old boy, it just doesn't hurt bad enough." And I love this story because even though the dog was howling in pain, the pain wasn't bad enough for him to do something about it. Instead, all he did was lay there in that comfortable spot on that porch in that summer heat on that nail because it didn't hurt bad enough to move. Now, you may be feeling kind of like that dog laying on that nail, like something in your life is painful or hurting. But you just don't know how to change. You don't know how to get up and move forward. And I felt that way until one day, my friend asked me a very tough question. I told him, "Man, I don't like to read." And he said, "Well, are you satisfied with the results?" I said, "Well, no." He said, "Then either stay where you're at or read, grow, and change. Become the person that God wants you to become." And so from that moment on, I started becoming the hungriest student, devouring all the good information I could, which has led to writing this book, Stand Taller, which has led to these principles being applied into my life. And I'm no longer that dog laying on that nail. And if you're feeling that way, then I'm so proud of you that you're willing to get up and get off that nail. Because there's millions upon millions of people who feel stuck, who are in that same situation. They feel like the best things in life are for other people. The best things in life have slipped through their fingers and they're just struggling with whatever is left. They have all sorts of self-defeating beliefs as to why they cannot achieve great things in life. They think they don't have enough money, or they feel like they're too dumb, too young, too old, or they don't have connections, or that the successful people just got lucky. In other words, they give themselves excuse after excuse as to why they remain frustrated. What if I told you that these are all illusions? What if I told you that they emanate from the things you choose to believe about yourself? Now, you have to understand this. There are people who have less money than you, or who have severe physical disabilities, who are able to do amazing things with their life. On the surface, these people have so little to work with, but they were able to rise above. Life may have given them lemons, but they sure know how to make a great pitcher of lemonade, like the stuff the old man on the porch was drinking. Now here comes the painful question. Why can't you do what they do? I'm going to tell you the truth. It all boils down to beliefs. We all have beliefs. You may be thinking to yourself that there's really no overriding belief governing your life. You may want to think about that for a second, and you might want to take a closer look. And that's what we'll get into the next episode. We'll look closer at the beliefs that we hold, and then we'll start to think about how we can get rid of the untrue beliefs, reprogram them. But first, we want to identify them, and then we'll start to find the positive beliefs. And I'm so excited for you to be tuned into this podcast, because we're going to go through a journey together. So stay tuned. Music is such a big part of my life. And so at the end of each episode, if you're listening on Spotify, you're going to be able to hear the full song. If you're listening on one of these other platforms, you'll be able to hear a 30-second snippet of it. But on every episode, as a part of the Culture Shift Challenge, we're going to have a new song for you to check out. And I thought this one was such an appropriate song. This song is called Drowning in the Media by Mr. Shamrock. Mr. Shamrock is the co-founder of Culture Shift Challenge. He's one of my best friends. He's actually even my cousin. But this song, what it means to me in this episode, is a lot of the untrue beliefs that we've picked up is from the media that we consume throughout our lives. It could be the relationships of our parents, our teachers, our peers, our brothers and sisters. It could be from the things that we listen to, the things that we watch, the things that we plugged into. And we're living in a world where we're drowning in this media, and much of it is negative and promoting things that are not true. And so I thought this song would be such a great song for you to check out, and for you to start to understand how powerful the media we have is. And so I look forward to you listening to this song. Make sure you check out Mr. Shamrock on YouTube. He has a new video coming out. I think you're being really excited. And I just want to thank you again for tuning in to the Stand Taller podcast. I'll see you next time. I'll see you at the top. So I'll see you real soon. Love you.